Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over the difference between a relative cell reference and an absolute cell reference in Microsoft Excel. So for our first sheet, we're going to define a relative reference. And our second sheet here, we are going to define for you an absolute reference.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So the default in Excel is to use a relative reference. So if I am in column C and I would like to add together everything in row 2 in column A and B, I can just type a formula that says equals, click on A2, hit the plus sign, and click on B2 and hit enter. And I can see that I'm getting a sum of 60, which is A2 plus B2. So this is correct. And if I click in C2, and you see this little square right here at the bottom right? If I hold that down with my left mouse button and I drag all the way down to the bottom, I can see that my formula is changing as I go to the cells below the initial one. So right here, I can see that I'm using row 2 for columns A and B to sum together. And then this one is using row 3 because I'm in row 3. This is using row 4 because I'm in row 4, and this is using row 5 because I am in row 5. That is called the relative reference.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
But sometimes I have a case like this. I have a case where I want to take what's in column B, and I want to multiply it by what is in a single cell over here. So I have sold 35 shirts, but each shirt is $20. And my total price should be whatever I have here multiplied by the 20 here. But if I do the same thing I just did with my relative reference, say I type equals B2 times E2, and I hit enter. If I click in C2 and I copy this formula all the way down, I'm going to end up with some zeros here when really I wanted this to be 10 times 20, and this would be 12 times 20, and this would be 84 times 20. But I can see that Excel has kept the relative reference of row 3, row 4, and row 5. So in this case, if I go back up to C2 and I click before the E2 and I put a dollar sign before the E and a dollar sign before the 2, and hit enter. Now if I click and copy my formula all the way down, I can see that the 2 is not changing because I have a dollar sign in front of it. Same on row 4 and same on row 5. However, the number sold is changing because that number is constantly changing. So by putting a dollar sign in front of my column and my row, I am keeping E2 locked in my formula right here. So we go into this topic a little bit more in depth on our blog, and I'm going to put a link to the blog entry for this topic below in the description on YouTube. So feel free to visit there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.